Go to the Tools panel in Affinity Designer and select maybe the rectangle or circle, etc. Doesn't matter. Create that design. Then go to the Pen tool and quickly create a path. Very basic path. Can be more complex. You could create all kinds of wiggly paths, zigzag paths, etc. Up to you. And then once you've done that, go to the brushes. You can find that in View menu and Studio and select, go to Watercolors, any of these paths, these brushes. So select that and you can see now you've got this brush. Go to Edit and Cut. Now I'm going to paste it inside this design. So make certain you've actually got that layer selected. That's a key thing. And then go to Edit and Paste Inside. So paste inside, and now you can see what happens. Never puts in the right place, but you can always move it. So you just move that there. And you can see now you've got your watercolor inside this design. You can also, once that's selected, you can go over here, make it 400. So you can actually make a nice watercolor effect right across there. And again, you can select it and you can hold down the Alt Option key, or maybe just duplicate it over here, perfectly reasonable. Hold that, and you can see then, as I just drag that across, I create this nice watercolor effect, and you don't have to make it perfect. You maybe apply a couple on top of each other and go across like that. Also, what you can do, you got that, you can go here to blend modes. So you can go for maybe darken, multiply, just to create some variation, or maybe go for add, those sort of things. Also, you can go to the node tool, just go over there to node tool, and you can vary it. So just move it slightly. If you just want to make slight variations, make a few additional points, manipulate it so it's not just straight perfect down. And also you can go to select another one and then maybe use blend modes for that as well. Or maybe go for opacity, set that to slightly less. But these are all paths, all designs that you can manipulate and move around. You can also select them all as well. And then you can just group them. So you just go there and right click and group. So they're all now grouped and I can move that around. So select there, move that there, reposition it, move that up there, maybe rotate it around. It's just a set of layers that's inside this design. You can move it that way so it's slightly different. Also, you can hold down the Alt Option key and duplicate that design. But you also, and I'm just going to remove that now, with all those designs, I can just recolor them as well. Just select that one. You know what? I don't want that one. I want, say, red. So you can create some variation. You can also select different watercolors. So you can select that one. Maybe go to this one and select a different one. But you don't also need to use watercolors. You could just go for, say, oils. So you've got oils there and just apply that. Go to this one, go to the oils again and select that. And again, vary the size. There's also other settings available as well. But you can say maybe make it 100 or 400. Again, change the colour, perfectly reasonable as well. So all kinds of designs can be created. And this can be then, let's just go to the top. So go to the rectangle and you can resize that rectangle. You can see you move it around. And also you can rotate the design. And also you can apply effects, etc. Especially if you've got Affinity Photo, you can go and quickly apply effects to that. But you've got a whole range of options here. Lots and lots of brushes that you can use and create all kinds of lovely filled designs. Hope you found this of interest. Thank you much.